coming from the military at that time, I'd been in the military about, I think, 12 or 13 years when I was selected. So, you know, coming to NASA from the military, as far as going into another training program, is fairly similar. I think NASA took some lessons learned from military training, especially flight school for me, was very much an analog to the kind of the training we had here. My first 6-hour run in the EMU, the spacesuit, was probably physically the most challenging thing I've done here. It's a pressurized suit. You're working with gloves that don't exactly fit you very well. You're doing a lot of work with your hands. Almost entirely for 6 hours, you're working with your hands and arms. So that was extremely physically challenging, I think, from start to finish. And by the time you're done with a 6-hour NBL run, you're pretty well exhausted. The psychological challenge, I think, for a lot of us, you know, we come from very high energy, high workload, high up tempo type jobs, and we're always going and doing things and working for that next goal. So I think psychologically, mentally, getting through that part of it is, I think, for most of us, pretty challenging. You know, year after year, working hard to be assignable to a spaceflight and then actually getting one. It is, I think, for me, was psychologically the most challenging thing that I've dealt with maybe in my entire professional life. I think it's just over the course of time, you get to that point where you know the best way to deal with these things is try to take the emotion and the human aspect of being, you know, nervous out of the equation, because in the end it doesn't really help you solve the problem. And I think the other part of it is it's just a case of you do it repetitively enough in simulations that I think you get to a point where you not only trust yourself, but you trust your crewmates and you trust the folks on the ground. Together, everybody kind of keeps a cool head and we work through the problem methodically. I think by and large, the first trait is someone who is willing to do anything for the team. You know, team player. Obviously, other things that I think are very helpful is you need to be proficient. You need to know your job. You need to keep a cool head. You need to kind of look at the problem pragmatically. But I think the biggest thing by far, in my opinion, is someone who is willing to do whatever it takes for the good of the team to make the mission successful.